So Twitter has announced this morning that they are actually nearing a deal to sell themselves to Elon Musk. So that's a thing that is most likely, you know, going to happen possibly today, maybe later this week. Who knows? But it does look like Twitter is going to be sold to Elon Musk. And that's a good thing too, right? Because if they don't, oh man, Ron DeSantis down here in the state of Florida, he is riding a high after taking on Disney last week. And he announced over the weekend that his next corporate target, of course, would be Twitter. You know, if you don't sell to Elon Musk, I'm coming after you. This is what he had to say. We're going to be looking at ways the state of Florida potentially can be holding these Twitter board of directors accountable for breaching their fiduciary duty. The state of Florida and our pension system, we have shares of Twitter. I didn't buy it. We have people that run the fund. But nevertheless, it hasn't exactly been great on returns on investment. It's been pretty stagnant for years, many, many years. To me, I think that is probably an injury to the fund. He then told folks to stay tuned to see what kind of actions he's going to take against Twitter, which, as we all know, is not run out of the state of Florida. So there's literally nothing he could do. Sure, they could sell the shares that Florida's pension fund holds, which if they're not yielding any returns, you should have already done that. Kind of seems like you're admitting that your state's not running your pension fund very well and you're actually screwing over retirees. I would think that you, knowing this, have a fiduciary duty to make sure you get the best return on investment for the retirees here in the state of Florida. Now, see what you've done here, Ron, because you're not a smart person. You've admitted to doing the same thing that you're accusing the Twitter board of doing, and that actually does open up the state to potential legal liabilities for knowingly investing in companies that are not yielding any returns. And you only want to get out of those investments now for political reasons, right? Because you're mad at Twitter, just like you were mad at Disney. So you decided to try to, quote, punish them. But what you really did was save them $163 million a year, and you shifted a cost of about $2,200 onto every family in the two counties that now make up that area. You're not punishing any corporation. You're doing them a hell of a lot of favors. But as I said, you've also now opened the state up to some possible liability for not doing their fiduciary duty. Here's what I don't understand about all of this, by the way. These Republicans who are out there cheering on Elon Musk buying Twitter are also the first people to point out how terrible it is that Jeff Bezos gets to own the Washington Post. What's the difference here? No, I'm asking. I don't have an answer. I seriously want to know. I want them to explain what's the difference. You know, why can you be against Jeff Bezos from Amazon owning the Washington Post, but you want Elon Musk to own Twitter? You can't support one and not the other. Right? Personally, I think they're both horrible decisions. But ultimately, I also think Republicans aren't going to get everything they've ever wanted from Elon Musk on Twitter. Marjorie Taylor Greene is out there this morning saying, woohoo, I'm going to get my personal account back. Like, how do you know that? Have you been having talks with Elon Musk? Because I'm pretty sure you haven't. And anyway, you tweeted that out on Twitter saying you're going to get your personal account back. So clearly you don't even need it because you're already on Twitter. Like, who gives a shit? I personally don't care if Elon Musk brings back all those people that have been banned from Twitter. That doesn't change my day whatsoever. I'll tell you what it does do, though. It reminds people of how crazy some of these individuals truly are. So, careful what you wish for, idiots. Because one of the things people hated the most about Donald Trump was his Twitter. So yeah, go ahead and bring it back. I promise you, it's not going to end the way that you think it is. This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.